Will the Edo State House of Assembly impeach Governor Obaseki? And the presidency considers the Revolution Now protest an irritation. This is PLUS Politics, and I am Felicity Ezewike. Welcome to the program. Few days after declaring support for the governorship candidate of the APC in Edo State, Osagie Ezeyamu, the Deputy Speaker of the Edo State House of Assembly was impeached from office and was replaced by Roland Asoro. However, another development has occurred, with 17 lawmakers of the Edo State House of Assembly, including 40 members whose seats were previously declared vacant, claim that they have impeached the Speaker of the House, Francis Okiye, and his deputy, Roland Asoro. The decision was announced at a private location hours after security officials took over the State Assembly complex. Joining us to discuss this in the studio is Liboris Oshoma, legal practitioner. Thank you very much for joining us.
My pleasure.
We also have joining us virtually the SHU, the governor of Edo State, Crusoe Osagie. Thank you very much for joining us as well. All right, I'm told we don't have the connection established. As soon as that is done, we'll bring him into the conversation. I'll start with you, Liboris. I mean, yesterday we heard that the speaker was impeached from the preamble. Now we know that the police laid, I wouldn't use the word siege now, they were at the complex, saying they want to forestall attack. And now we know that 14 lawmakers whose seats had been earlier declared vacant have been sworn in at a private location. Is the move backed by law?
Nigeria and our brand of politics will never cease to amaze me, really. It's so laughable. Everything that had been happening in Edo State, as far as legislature is concerned, none is backed by law. None at all, right from inception. If you remember, even the inauguration of the House of Assembly, even though you know some persons have argued that it was backed by law, the way and manner it was done also is not backed by law. Even the sitting of the existing seven members of the State House of Assembly and the way they had carried on over time for a year plus now also is not backed by law. And so, because Peter Obi, in the case of Peter Obi and INEC, the Supreme Court had heard, Peter Obi and the State, Anambra State House of Assembly, the Supreme Court had heard that the business of the assembly must be conducted in the place designated for such business. Also, the Supreme Court reiterated this in Laduja and Oyo State House of Assembly, when some lawmakers purportedly impeached Laduja in a D. Rovans hotel. For Peter Obi, the impeachment was purportedly carried out in a hotel in Asaba. And so, be that as it may, if you also remember before now, the Edo State House of Edo State government had purportedly, issued a notice to the effect that the House of Assembly was under fumigation. And then subsequently, he was from fumigation. Today we saw maize being removed from the roof.
Quickly,
so that I can paint a picture of why I said everything that had been happening, none had been backed up by law. And so, you also find out that the purported impeachment of the deputy speaker, the former deputy speaker, or the deputy speaker as the case may be, also was carried out in a place other than the place designated for the business of the assembly. And so, there had also been insinuation that the existing lawmaker had been sitting in a place at the government house, which is different from the place designated, the hallowed chambers of the State House of Assembly. So all of this that had been happening is what you call charade and shenanigans. And so it should not be encouraged at all. So everything, starting from the inauguration, the nocturnal inauguration, to what is happening today. But unfortunately, it will still take the court to make pronouncement.
We'll come back to that in a bit. But let's welcome Crusoe Osagie, the SHU, Edo State Governor on Media and Communication. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
All right. The APC denies bringing the police to the assembly complex and accuses the state government of carrying out several attacks against the constitutional independence of the assembly. Would it be fair that these developments have to say, rather, that this development had a lot more to do with the upcoming elections than the sanctity of the legislative arm?
Yeah, I can say very clearly without equivocation that, the APC and their sponsors, namely Adams Oshiomhole, Hope Uzodinma, who is a new entrant and one of the billionaires in Edo State, Captain Hosa Akumbo, who has been sponsoring them, they are bent on throwing the state into chaos. So we got intelligence that they had plans to invade the House of Assembly today, which is currently under renovation. And so the good people of Edo State, moved to that location to protect it and prevent it from being assaulted.
Yeah, this sudden renovation.
What we heard later was that these people went to gather in the residence of one former National Assembly member, Razak Bello Otsagi, where they purportedly inaugurated themselves. But let us put it on record that against what the person who was with you in the studio said earlier, the House of Assembly in Edo State has been duly inaugurated, and a court of competent jurisdiction in a judgment delivered on the 12th of September 2019 in a suit with suit number FHCBHCS15919 filed by Yekini Idai and others, has stated clearly that the House of Assembly on that date, 17th of June 2019, was duly constituted. And not only that, and that the governor cannot issue another proclamation for the inauguration of the House of Assembly. That judgment of 12th of September 2019 validates the House of Assembly in Edo State. So much as that man in the studio has said that it's not legal, it's completely wrong. A court has validated the existence of the House of Assembly.
All right, before I come to the legal practitioner to share his thought, I'm going to ask you, why the sudden move to renovate the assembly complex? Because before today, there was no information to that effect. And then we saw the police this morning, and then the next thing we saw was people renovating. Why this sudden move to renovate the complex?
A letter has since been sent to the public and to all relevant authorities in the state that some maintenance was going to happen in the House of Assembly. The maintenance started with initial fumigation, and then upon realization the extent of degradation of some aspects of the assembly, they saw that there was need to begin renovation. And that renovation had started, at a slow pace, which made us made the assembly to be relocated to what we call the old legislative chamber. I repeat, the old legislative chamber, which is where the House of Assembly used to sit when this state was called Bendel State. So it is not entirely a private location. It's the old legislative chamber that they have been located to.
Right.
And the current legislative chamber is undergoing renovation. So we believe that it is because the renovation has been at a relatively slow pace that these charlatans attempted to seize it. So we have now hastened up the process of renovation.
All right, I'll leave you on that. I would have loved to ask further question, but so we can manage time properly, I'll come back to you, Barrister Oshoma, to quickly explain your position from what he said. And then I'm going to ask you to speak on, would it be fair to say loads of this development has more to do with the election that we're expecting in September?
Yeah, let me start from the last one. I'll move to the first one. Yes, it all has a lot to do with the September election. It's all politicians will put in everything to win election, everything apart from governance. To win election. And so it is not novel to Edo State. That's what's been happening in Nigeria right from this Republic, and it's quite unfortunate. And so you find out that rather than politicians campaigning on the strength of achievements, what we see are thuggery, perfection of ballot box snatching, and then judgment purchase. I'm a lawyer, and so I speak on record. Inducement, allegations of bribery against judges and senior advocates, and you know, and all what's not. And at the end of the day, governance takes the backstage. You know, the people takes the backstage. What you see is thuggery, and you know, lies, falsehood takes center stage. And then coming to this issue of, I don't expect anything different from Crusoe, the spokesperson of the governor in Edo State. He's speaking. He's doing what he's paid to do, you know, speak for the government. So I excuse every spokesperson, including Femi Adesina, because they are paid to speak for and on behalf of a government and not for the people quickly. And so I told you, I cited a judgment, two judgments of the Supreme Court for you. The business of the assembly must be conducted in the place designated for the assembly. And so when you're renovating, you had issued circular to the fact that you were going to fumigate the assembly. It wasn't about renovation. Oshomole did the same thing to survive impeachment. He removed the roof of the entire assembly. And so it is not new. And so they are just perfecting the plans that was already in place before now. And then also the big question would be the same issue, the same scenario played out in Bauchi State. But at the end of the day, the Bauchi State governor allowed Wiseacre's counsel to prevail and inaugurated other members of the House. What is the Edo State government afraid about inaugurating and depriving other constituencies, including mine, of representation? And at the end of the day, the matter had been in court, because even the issue of declaring members' seat vacant had been sub judice. It's been in court. And so I had expected, democracy is a game of numbers, a situation where you consistently sit, seven people will sit to decide the budget of a state, seven persons will sit to decide the commissioner's nominees, seven persons will sit and say they have impeached, you know, a deputy that they appointed amongst themselves. For me, it's laughable. It's a mockery of democracy. And so when you come here and flout a court order before me, oh yes, a court validly made this that inauguration. Do you inaugurate a House of Assembly at night? Do you hound people who have validly won election to inauguration? You know, so let's, when we discuss democracy, we should, they say he who comes to equity must come with clean hands. Let's be fair and open to all parties. What you see play out here is all politics of whether we rule or we must rule or the other party wants to rule.
It's not about the people. Crusoe, you can react quickly, and then we have to talk about other issues, because
I'd like to let my friend there know. My friend there needs to understand that it's not about being emotional. He said he's a lawyer. He should focus on facts.
I'm emotional because I'm from the state, and I don't like what you guys are doing in the state.
Judgment.
Allow him to speak.
Court judgment. Can you allow me to speak, please? I cited a court judgment which was delivered in by High Court in Port Harcourt on September 12, 2019, validating the inauguration of the House of Assembly. And he erred again in the point of fact when he said that we prevented the 14 lawmakers who have not been inaugurated from coming to be inaugurated.
It's fact.
Nobody stopped them. They have been invited to come in and be inaugurated. They refused. Oshomole camped them in Abuja. He was paying them allowances in Abuja and ordered them, because it's their godfather, not to come and be inaugurated. Whose fault is that? That even though the house was open to them to come for inauguration, they refused blatantly to come and be inaugurated. So he's speaking there now sanctimoniously and taking the moral high ground and pretending as if he's speaking on behalf of the people, when he's actually perhaps a paid agent from the Somole camp. These people were not prevented from coming to the House of Assembly to be inaugurated. The House was open to them.
You said what?
They refused to come.
The validity of the inauguration has been established
by the High Court judgment. I didn't say an order. I said a judgment, a High Court judgment.
No, Crusoe, you just called me what?
They did not appeal that judgment.
Crusoe, please.
Crusoe, hold on.
No, really, I won't sit down here and allow him to come in.
Hold on.
The Federal High Court in Abuja.
Mr. Crusoe.
I need him to retract that statement quickly.
The declaration of their seats vacant by the Speaker.
Mr. Osagie, can I butt in? Mr. Osagie.
180 days.
Mr. Osagie, the conversation works when you talk and you allow others to respond and interject so we can all understand what we are saying. Now, there is a part of your conversation that might require some clarification. Mr. Oshoma is thinking he heard you say he is a paid...
I believe so.
Okay. Could you react to that quickly before we move on? Because we don't want to make this conversation about, accusation and counter-accusation.
I will not condescend to his level. I will not condescend to his level. Because, like I said, when you are paid to talk on behalf of government, you don't mind even insulting people rather than address issues.
I think that is inappropriate, sir.
Can we move on from this name?
No, I won't. I won't, really.
Let's talk about other issues. I won't dignify him
with a response. But really, let's take the issues one after the other.
All right. I want to talk about the fact that both parties are claiming the other is responsible for trying to take over the complex and scuttle the rule of law, so to speak. No one is sure who invited the police. At least as at the time we started this program, I hadn't seen any statement to that effect that maybe the IG ordered the police to go there, or the commissioner of police in the state did that. What should the Edo people, because all of this, now we're having a conversation about this and it's gone to other angles. So let's try and bring this conversation, because in all this conversation, we haven't seen the comment about what will benefit the what should be the focus?
My dear, that's the unfortunate part of this conversation. Before 2015, when we criticized Jonathan, they would say, Buhari people paid you. After 2015, when you criticize Buhari, they will say Jonathan paid you. So we're used to names like this. And as a citizen of Edo State, and I stand here to say that all of the campaigns and all of the issues, none of them has been about the people. And then this somebody who is speaking for the government says I'm paid to speak against the government.
That's what I'm going to.
Yeah. So that you can imagine the burden that the people in the state had to contend with when you confront the issues, when you confront government and ask questions. What is it about? What should the campaigns be about? What should, governance be about? The first issue I raised, I talked about the inauguration. You asked, your first question was about all that had been happening in Edo State. I said, starting from the inauguration to what transpired today, that none of them had been about the position of the law or about the people. And then secondly, on the issue of governance, really, one would have expected, I laugh when I listen to both sides, because all you just need to do is to go back to pre-2016 and listen to all the campaigns and the videos of some of these charlatans parading themselves today as leaders.
All right, Everything that they have said in
2016, they are saying today, and they want people to believe them, including the Mr. Osagie that you're talking about here.
Mr. Oshoma, please, let's go back to Mr. Osagie. And the same question that I asked Mr. Oshoma, I want to ask you, where is the Edo people? What should, because all of these, we're talking about protecting the State House of Assembly. We're talking about how the lawmakers are being inaugurated or not being inaugurated. Where is the interest of the Edo people in this? What would you be telling the Edo people to be focusing on at this time?
In fact, all the battle that Governor Godwin Obaseki has fought since he came against the resistance from Oshiomhole and his cohort in the APC has all been about the people. And the question has been, who do we spend the resources of government on? Should it be spent on a few individuals who call themselves leaders, political leaders, and so on and so forth? Or should the money be spent on Edo people? That's the crux of the battle. The governor has insisted that the government resources must be spent on the larger majority, and that's the people of the state. But the political class a few of them, you know, in the APC, you know, didn't agree with him, and they thought that the resources of the coach should be spent on them. That's what led to the attempt by Oshiomhole to seize control of the House of Assembly, which resulted in 14 members being ferried to Abuja and kept there and forced not to, to come in to be inaugurated. That's what resulted in today's crisis that we're talking about. Oshiomhole empowering these people to go and do what is clearly treasonable. You know, so it's all about the people. Obaseki's fight from beginning to end has been in defense of the survival of the average and ordinary Edo person,
right,
against the political hegemony that is trying to snuff life out of our people.
All right, Mr. Sage, I don't want you to give a rebuttal. I want you to talk about the folding events now. How is it going to, what are the likely scenarios? How is it going to affect the governorship pool? Because a lot of persons,
hold on,
Mr. Sage, let him also have a little bit of talk time.
Yes.
How are all of these going to play out for the governorship pool?
I have told you and I will say it. I'm not giving a rebuttal. I'm just telling you that governance in Edo State is not about the people. Otherwise, if it's about the people, I expected that we should be hearing how much was spent by the governor to get the PDP ticket. That's money also. Let me finish, please. That's money also, because we know how it goes. Party ticket don't come cheap. So if it's about the people, Governor Wike will not be talking about tax collectors in Edo State. If it's about the people, we should be seeing Ekawan Road had been under construction for as long as I can remember. We're talking Gele Port.
It's not up and to as 6 months.
As I speak to you.
Mr. Sage, you weren't happy when he interjected. So can you hold on and allow him finish?
I'm talking about how it will pan out. You can't talk about how it will pan out without talking about developmental stride, without talking about governance. Then, because people should look out for these things. These are things that people should look out for. Take the three geopolitical zone in Edo State. That's Edo North, Edo Central, and Edo South. Let's take all of them one after the other. You will look. Edo State was so bad under Lucky Igbenedion that the little that Oshiomhole did, people praised them to high heavens. I knew when Governor Professor Ambrose Ali was governor in Bende State.
When we talk about governance,
I feel bad when a governor today in Nigeria will mount the rostrum and say, I paid salary. And so that should be an achievement. I gave an appointment. I appointed somebody else from your area.
Mr. Oshiomhole, you still are not answering the question that I asked.
What should be the funds of the states that you say you do not want to spend on godfathers? How many roads were tarred?
All right, let's give Mr. Osage time to respond because this program is time bound. How many hospitals have been renovated? How many primary health care centers? These are the questions that the ordinary person like me should ask.
So hold on, let him speak. Let me go ahead, Mr. Sage. I said correctly that this man is not a
I think it's unfair to be like, calling Mr. Like Sage. You were called
allow
here.
Him, allow
hold
him.
On,
allow
hold him. On. Let me I am the anchor on this program, and I need both of you to calm down and let's talk about the issues. Mr. Sage, I think you should allow you speak on the issues instead of calling names, please.
If you call me name, I will respond.
Statements that have been made. Now, if the gentleman in the studio there was a truthful person, he will not say that Ekenwan Road has been under construction for as long as he can remember.
Yes.
The Ekenwan Road project started about 6 months ago.
No, not at all.
So you can't just come here and tell blatant lies.
Not at all.
Now, Edo State is a massive construction site as we speak. Transformation across the entire state. I will begin with civil service reforms. If you go to along Sapele Road in Benin City, you find 2 14-floor buildings that were literally built from scratch, standing and towering over the city right now, built from scratch and completed by this administration. If you look at the Ogbe Stadium, Samuel Ogbe Stadium as it's now called, it was literally torn down and rebuilt to Olympic standards as we speak in Edo State within the last 3 years. If you go to the High Court complex, you see a completely brand new High Court complex built from scratch and completed by this administration. If you go to Agualba Simi Street, you see about 15 units of housing built for all judges to live in Edo State, built from scratch and completed by this administration. If you go along Dennis Osadebe Way, you see a massive structure of a building built for the chief judge of Edo State.
Mr. Osagie, so
you want me to tell you the things we have done?
Mr. Osagie, because of time, I want it to be, I'm listening to you. Hold on, Mr. Osagie, I think it's not fair. He is speaking. No, it is not fair that you're laughing at his comment. Allow him speak. You have your opportunity. Mr. Osagie, please,
the
people.
Can I continue with the project?
We don't have a lot of time for you to list all of them, but what I want you to do.
I can go on and on.
Hold on. What I want you to do is speak.
Ask him to list another one.
Gentlemen, can you listen, please? What I want you to do is speak about the people now. The elections are coming. There are fears about some sort of violence because, I mean, you see security, you see people all over the place. There is tension. What would you say to Edo people that are watching this program right now that they have nothing to fear or they should be cautious or they should come out and vote? How is the development in Edo State going to encourage people to come out and cast their vote?
Are you still talking to me, Crusoe? Should I respond to that?
Yes, I'm talking to you.
Yeah, very simple. You see, the gentleman in the studio there, the gentleman, he knows that people are the people they are fighting against. As I speak to you today, at least 70% of the electorate in Edo State are restored. That whether waiting for some or another
on the list of them, Mr. Osagie, your line is breaking. Hello, could you maybe adjust your position a bit? We can barely hear you. Mr. Osagie, if you can hear me, we're having trouble getting your audio. Or could you maybe move a little and just quickly recap what you just said? Hello, Mr. Osagie. All right.
Can I?
Quickly,
please. About the people. Security, very, very key. I can give you the map of Edo State offhand from areas to areas. And it's unfortunate that when government refused to appreciate input from others without name calling, as we speak, with all the political rivalry going on, to the extent that the State House of Assembly will be taken over by the police.
All right.
Because of the issues that had played out before now.
Okay, we lost Osagie. I'm sorry to interrupt, but we need to give him time to conclude and then we'll come back to you in the studio. Mr. Osagie, the audio while you were talking went off. So please, could you quickly recap?
I was trying to say to you that as we speak today, it is Obaseki and Edo people on one side, then Oshiomhole and a few brigands on the other. If you take an independent survey of Edo electorates today, at least 7 out of every 10 persons want to vote for the governor. And that is
my question again is, with all of this that is going on, what would you say to Edo people? To encourage them to come out and vote without fear.
Let me land on your answers. So at least 7 out of every 10 Edo persons want to vote for the governor. And to that extent, they are all ready to go out en masse on election day in pursuit of free pools to cast their votes for the governor. And come September 19th, of the governor, Godwin Obaseki, will be re-elected as governor because the majority of the people want him back.
All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Osagie. We're actually out of time, but I wanted you to conclude your thought. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Mr. Riboros, in 40 seconds, max.
You gave him 2 minutes. I was looking at my time.
You spoke more before him, so please.
But I won't argue all of that. Politicians in Nigeria, like comedians, comic relief, you asked him a question about the people. He's talking about, they're already ready voting for him. I expected with all of this brigandage going on in Edo State, how do you assuage, how do you provide security? You know, that also now brings us to the issue of whether we should have state security or not, or whether federal police should consistently provide security. As I speak now, I cannot travel from Benin to Auchi without fear of being kidnapped. And so, when you have that rife, you also have the issue of ballot box snatching hanging over. So this brings me to the question of what INEC should do. I think there is time for us to begin to reform our electoral practices and laws. We just conducted NBA election. I didn't leave Lagos. I didn't leave my bedroom, but I voted. So INEC should begin to look at all of these options so that the people's vote can actually count. And not all of this brigandage, ballot box snatching, and jamborees that we see in campaign. You do that, you should, at that time, you would now be ready. People will be ready to question, you know, whatever anybody says at campaign, and not what we have currently. What we have currently is what we encourage the like of Osagie Crusoe to come, call people's names, and just the same way, they reduce every campaign to Oshomole, rather than show what they have done for the people that will make the people truly vote for them. It's unfortunate, really.
Mr. Liberus Oshoma, thank you very much for joining us on the program. Quite a passionate exchange, I would say.
Because I'm from Edo State, and I want my state to be developed, and not what we already have.
Well, the conversation will certainly continue here on Plus Politics in the coming days. We expect to see a further development. We hope for the better and not something that will put fear in the people of the state. Thank you for staying with us thus far, but we're not done yet. We'll take a short break, and when we return, the presidency tells us what it thinks about the Revolution Now protest. We'll be right back.